In this session, let us look into the process of image sampling and quantization. Images are denoted by two-dimensional function of the form f of x, y. The value of f at spatial coordinate x, y is a scalar quantity whose physical meaning is determined by the source of the image and whose values are proportional to energy radiated by a physical source. Hence, f of x, y will be non-negative and finite. This figure represents the procedure of image acquisition. We can see in the figure that the energy from an illumination source is being reflected from a given scene. Further, the imaging system collects the incoming energy and focuses it onto the image plane. The front end of the imaging system is an optical lens that projects the viewed scene onto the focal plane of the lens. The sensor array, which is coincident with the focal plane, produces outputs proportional to the integral of the light received at each sensor. Digital and analog circuitry sweep these outputs and convert them into analog signal, which is then digitized by another section of imaging system. There are various ways to acquire images. The objective in digital imaging is same with respect to acquired images. The images are to be converted into digital image. To create a digital image, we need to convert continuous sense data into digital format. This requires two processes, sampling and quantization. Now let us see the basic concept in sampling and quantization. Consider the image given in figure that is to be converted into digital form. An image may be continuous with respect to x and y coordinates and also in amplitude. To digitize it, we have to sample the function in both coordinates and also in amplitude. Digitizing the coordinate value is called sampling and digitizing the amplitude value is called quantization. This figure is a plot of amplitude, that is intensity values of the continuous image. That is the right side, image given in the right side where the mouse is pointing to is the plot of amplitude, that is intensity value of the continuous image that is given on the left along this particular line segment AB. The random variation, what you can see here in the right side image, is due to noise. To sample this function, we take equally spaced samples along the line AB, as shown in this figure. You can see that the samples are depicted as small dark squares superimposed on the function, and their spatial locations are indicated by corresponding tick mark shown in bottom of the figure. The set of dark squares constitute the sampled function, and in order to form a digital function, the intensity values must be converted into discrete quantities. The vertical gray bar depicts the intensity scale divided into 8 discrete intervals ranging from black to white. Hope you can see it here on the right side. You can see a vertical bar which depicts the intensity scale divided into 8 discrete intervals. These values are ranging from black to white. And the vertical tick mark indicates the specific value assigned to each of the 8 intensity values. The continuous intensity levels are quantized by assigning one of the 8 values to each sample depending on the vertical proximity of a sample to the vertical tick mark. The digital samples resulting from sampling and quantization is shown with the white squares here. The mouse is hovering over the white squares. So these squares are the digital samples resulting from sampling and quantization. Starting from the top of the image and moving line by line downwards, we get a two-dimensional digital image. In this figure, it illustrates a continuous image that is projected onto the plane of a 2D sensor when converted. And here, the right-hand side image you can see after sampling and quantization. To conclude, in this session we learned the process of sampling and quantization to obtain a digital image. Thank you.